there, I'm Stephanie Langston for Yallwire in Nashville at Cabana, where we are celebrating Jake Owen's second number one, Alone With You.
You don't call me back, but you kiss me when you're drunk.
Jake, you've been at this for a long time, but you hit your first number one within the past year, and here we are at your second. Do you think this is like a roll momentum that you have going on, and what's the secret?
I hope so. You know, I don't know what the secret is. I just know that hard work and dedication to what you believe in, it pays off. These songs that have gone number one for me, Barefoot Blue Jean Night, which is the, you know, title track of my album, went number one. It was a multi-week number one, which was mind-blowing for me that my first number one be multi-week. And then Alone With You was a multi-week number one. So the first two songs off this album hit the number one spot, and I'm just lucky that neither one I wrote. I'm so lucky to share it with people like JT and Shane McAnally and Catt Gravitt that wrote the song. I could not do what I'm doing these days without the people behind me that are allowing me to do this and going out every day and working hard to make sure that it happens.
The last time I talked to you two was actually right here at Cabana for your first number one with Kenny Chesney. Yeah. Walking in today, is it any different than it was the first time?
It's a thrill. I'm equally as excited. It feels no different. I'm this is just a blast, and it's Catt's first number one. How do you feel, Mr. Shane McAnally?
I mean, that's probably a little better. I mean, we get to stand with Catt. So.
Oh, Catt, you have a number one in Christian, but
yes.
This is your first country.
Yes.
How's it feel to cross over into the charts?
It feels a lot better to not. Sometimes there's some boundaries with what you can and can't say in other genres, and it just it feels amazing. It's very exciting, and to be with friends, it's all the more special because we've been a dear friend of ours has been trying to get all of us together for a really long time. So,
is this the first time you guys have written together?
Yes.
And take us to that day. Was it a quick write or?
I feel like, if I remember correctly, which I think some of the stories have gotten, you know, you remember differently,
yeah.
But I think it felt like it was going to be a really quick write, and we had everything laid out, and I think we were about to work tape it, and Catt had an instinct about the chorus. We did have a completely different chorus written over the same melody, and it just didn't have, and she said, you know, I just wish that it was like hands on skin and mouths and... She said, I just feel like it needs to, I can't remember verbatim, but I know she said, I want it to feel real. And JT and I were like, yeah, well, let's, I mean, I think a lot of times when you've been writing all day and you get to that point and someone says that, you're at first like, really? I mean, this chorus, it rhymes and it goes in the melody real nice.
And it's lunchtime.
Yeah, and it's lunchtime. But she said, you know, I want to feel it. And and we got there. We decided to dig in, and I'm so glad you said that. I mean, that's what it takes. That's the difference between a song getting cut and not. Somebody speaking up and saying, we can make this better, and you did. I'm really glad you did.
Don't put your lips up to my mouth and tell me you can't stay. Don't slip your hand under my shirt and tell me it's okay. Don't say it doesn't matter, cause it's gonna matter to me. I can't be alone.
Let's talk about the storyline behind the song. Is this basically somebody who just wants a booty call regularly but no commitment? That's what I got out of it.
I think a lot of women can relate to the part where it's like there are certain people that you have chemistry with. And even if it is a booty call and some people are relating to that, I think for me it was more about there are certain people where you can't be in a room with. I mean, look at them across the room because the chemistry is so hot and maybe you're not supposed to go there. So it's real life. I mean, it definitely exists. And I think if we sat everybody down and you had to tell the truth, there's somebody that you have hot chemistry with, but you don't necessarily end up with them for a lifetime.
Right.
Hey, Mom, who's your booty call? We don't want to ask everybody.
How do you guys feel that Jake took that kind of meaning behind the song, and how did he do with it, interpreting it?
Oh.
A+, in my opinion. He knocked it out of the park, home run.
Because first of all, he was single at the time. He's a beautiful man, and I think a lot of women, I think they wanted to hear something like that from him, personally.
Vulnerable.
And it's vulnerable. It's a... For somebody like him who usually could get any woman that he wants, it was nice to see that vulnerability in a man, and the fact that he went there is just amazing.
I absolutely agree. I mean, I hope it's not too big of a statement to say that I think him saying that, it opened the doors for other men in country to say that. Usually it's the woman who is chasing or being left or being led on. And that happens to guys too. I'm so glad he said it.
So put your lips up to my mouth and tell me you can't stay. Don't slip your hand under my shirt and tell me it's okay. Don't say it doesn't matter, cause it's gonna matter to me. I can't be alone with you.
And take us back to that music video. It gets pretty hot and steamy. How does Lacey feel about that?
She's all right about it. It's over now. You know, I can't say that the first, you know, few days after she saw it, it was like her favorite thing she's ever seen me do. But, you know, it was something that needed to be done. You know, when I record a song, I'm gonna give it everything I have. I'm gonna make it real. I'm gonna make it as truthful as possible. And you know, if you're gonna spend the money to make a video, you need to do something that when people see it, they're like, wow, I've been there before, I get that feeling. And that's kind of what I wanted to do, and I think it paid off. And I really fought for this song to be the second song off my record that was released. And thankfully, because it hit the top spot, you know, all the fighting I did was well worth it.
Well, I know you've been really busy. You're on the Brothers and Sons tour. How's that going so far?
It's really, really well. Kenny and Tim and Grace Potter are just some of the coolest people I've ever been around. And the size venues we're playing, these stadiums, football mm-hmm. stadiums, is doesn't get any bigger than that, you know. And I don't know what you would play outside of a stadium. And I'm just honored that they'd have me out there, and we're doing really, really well. People are really responsive to what we're doing, so I feel like everything's kind of rolling in the right direction.
Up to my mouth and tell me you can't stay. Don't slip your hand under my shirt and tell me it's okay.